Hello, dear students, I am welcome you for the second unit of the cell biology. So in the second unit, this is the syllabus content you are going to see. Okay, so this is the syllabus content. In this, the first and foremost important thing is related to the structure and functions of the cell wall. What is the structure and what is the function of the cell wall? While we are going into this lecture, okay, in the cell wall, we will look at where it is present, what is its importance, all these points. Cell wall is something that is present outside to the cell. It is the one present outside to the cell or even outside to the cell membrane. Okay, so this thing you can visualize here in this image. You just look at this image. So this is a bacterial cell. You can able to see the cell wall that have been present outside. You look at the image carefully. Here, this image, the red color refers to the capsule. Okay, so that is the one which is found external completely to the cell. You can see the other two things, that is a blue color coating and a white color coating. The white color one refers to the plasma membrane. However, the cell wall which is present outside to the plasma membrane is shown here in the blue color. Okay, so the cell wall is present in which kind of organisms are all? That is, which organisms are all found to have a cell wall? We will look at here. Plant cell is having the cell wall. Bacterial cell is having the cell wall. Then fungal cell is having the cell wall. Then what are the other organisms are commonly present? You look at the point related to the animal cell. Animal cell. Okay. The question is the animal cell is having the cell wall? No. It don't have cell wall. Then protozoa, which also comes under the animal, is it having a cell wall? No, it is not having a cell wall. Then viruses, is there having a cell wall? Some viruses will be having a cell wall. Say, look at this image of the virus. It is having a or envelope. It refers to the cell wall of the virus. However, some virus may not have a cell wall. Say, for example, you look at the bacteriophage. Bacteriophage is having a protein coat. This is a protein coat, and inside it will be having only just a nucleic acid there. So some will be having a cell wall and some may not be having a cell wall. So this one is may or may not. So these are all the various living organisms that have been present there in the earth, which found to have the cell wall, and these are the one which don't have a cell wall. Okay, if they are having a cell wall, what is the role of the cell wall? Cell wall is entirely related to the protection. Okay, we will see the points later. Now we will look at cell wall is made up of what. Say for example, plant cell wall is made up of cellulose. Cellulose are in turn made up of glucose units. Bacterial cell wall are made up of murine. It is made up of murine, which is in turn made up of two subunits, that is N-acetyl glucosamine and N-acetyl muramic acid. Okay, shortly they used to call this one as a NAC, which is referred as a NAG, N-acetyl glucosamine. However, N-acetyl muramic acid is referred as a NAC, N-acetyl muramic acid. Okay. So, this is the cell wall component of the bacterial cell. The next one is a fungal cell wall. Fungal cell wall is again made up of N-acetyl glucosamine. That is, fungal cell wall is composed mainly of N-acetyl glucosamine. Apart from this organism are all, one more found to having a cell wall is algae. Okay, algae will be actually coming under the plant cells. Plant cell and algae. Algae and plant cell will be united together. Both will be having the cellulose as an important constituent. Next one is the what are the functions that will be carried on by the cell wall in any kind of organism? Some generalized functions of the cell wall. The first one is, as I already told, it determines the shape and structural support for the organism. Cell wall is the one which determines the shape and the structural support for the organism. Next one, cell wall gives cells rigidity, strength, and offering protection against the mechanical stress. So cell wall is the one which gives more strength and rigidity, and it also offers some sort of protection against the mechanical stress. So cell wall is something flexible. It is a bend rather than holding a fixed shape. That is, it's a flexible structure and it is not a fixed one. It has a considerable tensile strength, and the apparent rigidity of the primary plant tissues is a function of hydraulic turgor pressure. This point is related with the plant tissues, plant associated cell wall. That is, the plant tissues rigidity is maintained by hydraulic turgor pressure of the cells, and it's not just due to the rigid cell wall. That is, water that conducts there in the plant cells will create a hydraulic turgor pressure which maintains the rigidity of the plant cell wall. Next one, cell wall also limits the entry of large molecule that may be toxic for the cells. So cell wall plays a major role in limiting the entry of large size particles. The next one, it further permits the creation of stable osmotic environment by preventing osmotic lysis and helps to retain water. That is, it is a semi-permeable nature, and it allows the passage of some small molecules and small proteins inside. Say for example, it can able to pass substance up to 30 to 60 kilodalton in size. That is, 60,000 dalton substances can pass through inside the cell wall. However, after entering into the cell wall, to move inside the cell membrane, the substances size should be always lesser than 600 Dalton. Okay. Only molecules of less than 600 Dalton can move inside the cell membrane by passive diffusion. So these are all some salient points that have been common in most of the cell walls. That includes the bacterial cell wall, fungal cell wall, or algal cell wall, as well as the plant cell wall.